for day two.
All right, so we're gonna try a live bait this time. So let's see if we can grab some mullet out of this river real quick, because we failed so horribly last time in this river using artificial lures. All right, so we got a couple of baits. Now we're gonna put the boat in the river and head upstream. And on the way up, we're also gonna drop a shrimp trap in. So if we can't catch any fish, maybe we can at least catch some shrimp as our fallback plan. You see any fish up here today?
There's some catfish.
Really?
Okay, so when you go up the river, you're gonna see a port, right? If you go to the top of that river, just imagine being in this boat and not being able to go any further.
Okay.
You then stop right there and look to the left and to the right side. There's huge catfish.
All right, so taking the advice of the nice gentleman that we just met here at the tour company, we're gonna troll a little bit. So maybe before we get to the good fishing ground, maybe we can pick up a mangrove jack trolling. So we're gonna troll this old Rapala here. It was probably built for smallmouth bass in North America. And we're gonna see if we can pick up a mangrove snapper or a mangrove jack.
So this is really cool. We saw these land crabs last time and we were able to get them on camera, but a lot of people eat the land crabs. I think they tear apart coconuts, and so people capture them similar to the coconut crabs. But those are massive. I have never seen any that size. I think Chris is gonna try cast netting again.
Looking at expert bounce here.
We're all flashing. Not our new fish are just so skinny.
Oh, we just spit through.
Rock bottom.
Okay, another round of failure from Candy Adventures.
You're rock bottoming.
I am. But really, today's trip is not so much about catching fish, which we would absolutely love to do. But today is more about testing my Richard Dean Anderson job that we have here on the back of the boat. I don't know if you want to let Elizabeth tell the story or not, but we have a new piece of equipment on the boat today, and that's a pump. And we never bring a pump along. And you might say, why in the hell would you bring a pump along in your fairly new boat that you trust and have faith in? Well, Elizabeth decided she was going to use it one time by herself and with her friends. And now our boat has a giant hole in it.
Chris, what you do?
Fixing the boat that someone broke. That I have repaired with glue and expanding foam from Home Depot and some caulking. And so basically we're out here on a wing and a prayer today. So if we don't catch a fish, I'm okay as long as we don't lose everything we own and sink into the bottom of this river and die in the jungle today. So.
Are you sorry? Do you think it's funny?
So aside from testing the boat today, we do want to catch something, and we still have little faith in our fish catching abilities, especially we just came across a guy who said he caught a 3-pound mangrove snapper. We're not beating that today. So our fallback is this shrimp trap.
This is our little store-bought shrimp trap. And we're just gonna jam this pouch full of some oysters. Some delicious smoked Geisha brand oysters here.
For some reason, this current is super strong today.
Yeah, last time we were up here, there was no current. And I guess there's a big tide change maybe. And there is a lot of current, which is making filming and fishing this kind of annoying. Now we're just gonna find a good place up under the bank and throw the shrimp trap, tie their other end off, and let it do its work while we continue to fish with our live bait.
What is happening?
All right, I just took a mental snapshot of where this is in the jungle. So I've locked that, I've burned that into my memory pretty well, so we're not gonna forget where this is at.
Definitely not.
Not a lot of processing power in this old CPU, but she does her job.
We've set the trap and gone farther upriver. Because this current is pushing so strongly, we've seen so many crabs just floating along the water. So we think some fish will probably be coming down this way as well. And we've put our two live baits on a hook with a little sinker, and we're just sitting and drinking beer.
We also were told, we've heard this a few times, I don't know if it's a rumor or myth, but we were told by the nice gentleman down there that there's catfish up here. So that'd be kind of cool to catch a catfish. We've also heard rumored that there's peacock bass in some of this fresh water. I've never actually seen one or one of the catfish, but I've heard the rumor. So the mystery of the unknown in this river is kind of neat. I always like some mystery.
Not really knowing what you're going to get.
And that's why I sometimes get bored fishing freshwater in the States, is you know all five species of fish that are in that lake. But here it's kind of neat because you're not really sure what could be in here. We could catch a trevally up here, or snapper, or some species that somebody's brought in and dropped off in here. So really kind of neat, just the unknown. So these little crabs are the ones that keep floating down the river by us. So we're going to use that for bait too next.
Is it male or female?
Probably.
Yes.
It's probably a male or female crab.
Thank you.
Genus subspecies Crustacea.
We spent exactly one beer here in this spot, and I think it's too muddy for any of the fish to see our live bait, so we're gonna go to the other side of the fork. We saw a bunch of fish there last time, but now we're prepared with live bait, so hopefully that works. Who knows?
Second location, we got our live bait out, our juvenile jacks, or EE, I think they're called. We've only had to get Elizabeth unhung up twice now, so we're not doing too bad.
I have the longer rod.
The sun is starting to come down in the sky a little bit, so we're hoping, fingers crossed, that we have some good luck here. And if not, our last-ditch effort, we're hoping that there are shrimp in our shrimp trap. The sun's starting to go down, and we're starting to get a few small bites, but nothing big enough to actually take the hook yet. So, but it's good to at least have a couple of bites instead of just being absolutely skunked here.
Like last time. So I got a fish on mine, and it has drug it straight into the weeds.
Does it feel good?
Yeah, it feels pretty good.
You can tighten the drag down a little bit. That drag set really loose. We have a catfish.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Was not expecting to catch a catfish here in this tropical island of Guam, but we have a big, I don't know what kind of catfish this is.
Whoa!
But this was all buried down in the weeds. So anyway, Elizabeth caught a big catfish.
Chris casted it, though. I just held the pole. Props to him, not me.
So we caught this on EE on some live bait that has since died, but we caught this on EE way up here. So here's our catfish.
That thing's huge. Look at like the length of your torso.
Yeah, was not expecting to catch a freshwater catfish up this river. in the middle of the Pacific Islands.
I thought it was rumors for sure. Yeah,
I thought it was rumors that there were catfish in those rivers, but here it is. There are catfish in the rivers here on Guam. So very interesting, very neat. So I've caught nothing except tiny fish in a cast net today, but I don't even care. You know, it's not about catching the fish, because I don't give a shit. I don't give a shit if every time we go fishing, she catches the biggest fish, biggest shrimp. It's not even something I think about. I don't think about it. I don't dwell on it. I won't think about it tonight and get very little sleep and go to work with dark circles under my eyes because it does not matter to me. When you're in a relationship, all it's about is seeing someone else happy because you'd rather them be happy all the time than you ever get to be happy. All right, the sun's starting to get a little low. I don't think we're going to catch another fish, which is okay because Elizabeth caught a pretty nice sized catfish here. And I've got a real soft spot in my heart for Long John Silver's. So we Googled the Long John Silver's fish batter recipe. So I think we're going to try to make some catfish Long John Silver's style sandwiches. But first, I'm going to reel this pole in and we're going to go check our shrimp just to see if our shrimp trap got anything.
I think a pig is getting murdered.
Okay, so that fucking terrifying sound are the pigs that live here on Guam. And when you're not expecting it and you hear that shit in the woods, it's the most terrifying sound in the world.
When you hit the dead end, you know you've gone too far and missed where you placed your trap. Turning around.
Oh. Empty.
There's definitely our can is still in there. And nothing.
Perfect.
Good thing we didn't bet on this.
All right, so we didn't get any shrimp, but today was a complete success. Not just because Elizabeth caught a catfish in the middle of the Pacific Islands, which still blows my mind, but because we didn't sink. Our boat is still floating and holding full air. It didn't leak at all. We didn't have to pump it back up, so...
Is this my redemption? Is that I caught a fish so it makes up for putting a giant hole in the boat?
No, that is not her redemption. But we are going to go fillet this catfish out and make some sandwiches out of it. So let's get back to the truck. So we're filleting these here at night outside beside the river. Where we live, there's nowhere to put the fish guts and the carcass, so we've learned our lesson in the last few months of filleting fish in our small place with no jungle behind it, because our trash can smells like an absolute just atrocity the next morning after we have fish. So we're doing it here before we get back to the house. That's why the lighting's kind of bad for this video. Unlike last video, where we caught literally nothing.
Bink, zero.
Much like Mr. Capella here from Elizabeth's artwork and my birthday present of the greatest musician of the 1980s. I still believe today can have a taste.
Here it comes!
Of the island.
It took 2 hours to set this up, so we're gonna hang on this shot for a little bit. Check that out. Pretty cool.
Chris got it from the grocery store. Yeah.
We have over 500 subscribers now, so it's time to up the production game.
See this? It's nice. So this array of ingredients on the counter is for our recreation of one of our favorite fish fry batters of all time, Long John Silver's.
So we're going to turn our catfish that Elizabeth caught, which is a...
air-breathing catfish. So definitely different than the catfish that we have in North America. So if you're stateside watching this, they are not the same. They're still a type of catfish, but completely different family, which is pretty cool. And they are from Southeast Asia.
Actually, I think we have some updates on the species. And we were looking around, and I think that this is an African sharp-toothed catfish, which was introduced in the Philippines for aquaculture, but originally is from Africa. So I think this is an African sharp-tooth catfish that we caught on Guam, which is kind of neat. Back to Elizabeth.
And they have this really cool organ called a labyrinth organ that allows them to literally breathe air.
So when all the other catfish are being a real Jordan Sparks, these catfish can still breathe with no air. Somehow I'm still alive inside. You took my breath, but I survived. And so we Googled, we spent hours on forums figuring out what Long John Silver's fish recipe is.
Let's get to it.
Let's cut the bloodline out of this catfish and get to batter dibbity.
Batter dibbity?
But anyway, we wanted to show this meat. We're used to catching fish. The catfish that are of a whiter meat, and the fillets in this they almost look like salmon or something.
Salmon or tuna, like it's a very unique color, it's very bright. For our recipe, we're mostly going off of food.com and their very controversial comment section underneath. I think I'm going to do a quarter cup corn flour and then half a cup regular flour. 2 tablespoons of cornstarch.
I've been on a bit of a nostalgia kick lately as a child of the 80s.
1/4 teaspoon of baking soda.
Paul Hogan was a big inspiration for me. And here, Mr. Capella.
Followed by 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder. And then we're gonna just eyeball the seasoning.
Richard Dean Anderson, MacGruber, Mick Dundee, Mr. Tim Capella. Those are some things I just wanted to talk about because I knew there was going to be a lot of, I didn't know what else to do with my hands, that old classic thing with Will Ferrell. I didn't know what to do while Elizabeth was doing all the work here, so I thought I'd just ramble.
I'm not sure what to do with my hands.
Be good just to hold them down by your side. Yeah, great.
Well, we're real happy with what was going on.
If you've got an 80s icon that you would like to discuss or reminisce, I'd like to reminisce with you. Let's reminisce together. Go ahead and drop it down in the comments section.
Mix it up.
Gotta get it mixed, gotta get it fine. She gonna bring it up like some fine wine, but she gonna mix it up, get that powder hotter, get that powder whiter, get that powder snotter.
Okay. Snotter?
All right, while she's doing this, we're gonna go ahead and get some canola oil, which is the same thing that Long John Silver's uses.
Someone forgot before we filmed to clean this up before the whole internet saw all of our
how messy we really are. Don't even lie.
What's better than our golden fried Alaskan whitefish?
Dipped into a golden beer batter.
It fries Alaskan whitefish to a golden perfection.
So hopefully it's cooked and hopefully this doesn't taste like ass. But I'm always optimistic like Mr. Tim Capella here, so more than anything, I just really want Tim Capella to see this video and hit us up. Tim, you're the coolest saxophone player that ever lived. All right, so just like report of the week, freshwater catfish in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, Long John Silver style, going in. It's good. Very good. Mm-hmm. It's very crunchy. Mm-hmm. The catfish is not fishy tasting whatsoever. Mm-mm. So this is delicious. So we're going to go ahead and pound this and sip on a few of these and enjoy this. So I hope you enjoyed our freshwater catfish surprise Guam Pacific Islands catch and cook surprise. We didn't think we were going to catch a freshwater fish.
But we did, and it wasn't a mangrove snapper, but still cool.
Yeah. So, thanks for sticking around, and we're going to go ahead and finish this fish up, and hope you guys stay tuned for our next video.
Yeah. Thank you so much for watching all of our content. For the few that have stuck around since the beginning, you're amazing.